millions of people right around the world, Julie Andrews represents a golden age of acting. The star of such classics as The Sound of Music, Mary Poppins and My Fair Lady caught up with our Angela Bishop to talk about her life in the spotlight.
I could have danced all night.
For well over half a century, Dame Julie Andrews has been the queen of stage and screen. Now in her 80s, this devotee of the arts isn't slowing down anytime soon. There's the new movie, a children's TV show. And now she's back in Australia directing a second season of the revival of My Fair Lady, in which she first starred on Broadway 61 years ago. Dame Julie, such
Hello.
A delight to see
Hello.
You again. They've had a bit of a break since the Sydney season
yes,
last
they have.
Year. So what did you have to do to get everyone...
Well, you know, I thought, oh, I'm going to have to pull everybody back up to a certain kind of standard and tension. They'd worked on their roles and never let them go.
Just help her along, darling, you'll be quite safe.
Charles Edwards, who is now our Higgins.
A lot of people will know Charles from Downton Abbey, actually,
yes.
won't they?
Oh,
They'll
yes.
recognise him
yes.
from that. But he was a terrific Higgins last night, and a different Higgins.
Yes, very different.
Good afternoon.
While the character Eliza has to learn to speak well, whoever plays Eliza
has to learn to speak Cockney, yes.
Has to learn to speak Cockney,
yes.
Which is not an easy feat.
Yes. So I had an American professor of phonetics teaching me English Cockney when I first began to study for the role. It was all muddled.
I wouldn't have ate it, only I'm too ladylike to take it out of your mouth.
Well, that's pretty good. Now let's try it with the chocolate.
Uh-oh.
All I want is a room somewhere.
So how does our Aussie Eliza compare?
Well, she's spectacular. The range that she has and the height that she has is beautiful and it's warm.
Welcome, my greenies. Away from the stage, Andrews has been busy developing her very own TV show called Julie's Green Room.
For the stage.
So I haven't had time to binge the full 13 eps, but I will get there. What a terrific concept. Why did you want to do this?
It's just been a passion of mine and my daughter's also to bring them the wonder of the arts at a young age.
Do you mind, please? When you act, it's a whole other world when you act.
And you're a bit like Kermit was, running the show back
sort
in the
of,
Muppet
yes,
Show
Yes, sort
day.
Of, yes. And teaching a different subject every week.
Here's what you need to do. Take a leap.
Every episode we have a new guest star who teaches a masterclass of their particular craft.
It's time to start our acting class.
We have ballet and we have singing. I mean, we have everything.
Guests include Alec Baldwin, Carol Burnett and Josh Groban, just to name a few.
Fire up the bus, Gusties.
Julie's made the show to counter the backlash the arts community is facing from forces like Donald Trump. Do you think Donald Trump sees the artistic community somehow as the enemy?
I know his priorities and they're not in the arts, that's for sure. There's so much research on what the arts can do for young children as they grow up. They become better citizens, better students, better human beings and more compassionate, and they transcend countries. Talk about a hand across the water. You couldn't do better than be involved with the arts.
And you'd be hard-pressed to find a stronger advocate for children in the arts. At the age of 12, Andrews sang for King George VI in front of thousands.
That was a Royal Command performance, which their majesties attend every year. That year, the headliner was Danny Kaye. There was a lot of publicity of my sitting on his lap, and talking to him, and it was sweet.
How old are you?
I am 12. How old are you?
I think I'd better ask the questions.
You started working very young.
Very young.
How young is too young?
If the child is interested and passionate, and I mean, even if it's just going to a music class and just banging on a drum and having fun with it. If the child really shows interest, then it's never too young.
From very early on, Julie knew what it was like to be a working mum on set. And today, one of her daughters, Emma, works right alongside her.
We run a publishing company together and we've written, I guess now, over 30 books.
In 2000, in recognition of a lifetime of service to the performing arts, Julie Andrews was made a dame by Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. So I had to ask, have you hung out with the Queen much as a result
hung
of that?
Hung out.
Do you get to go round for a cup?
I don't know if Her Majesty gets to hang out with anybody. I'm a great fan of hers. I'm a great admirer because she works so hard.
Hello, Mom.
I just wanted to congratulate you on stealing the pyramid.
That was you, wasn't it?
You managed to squeeze in another Despicable Me movie.
Yes.
Number three, you're back
as
Mom.
Worst character I've ever got to play, and I absolutely adore her.
Someday I'm going to go to the moon.
Oh, I'm afraid you're too late, son. NASA isn't sending the monkeys anymore.
She is despicable. She's far more despicable than her son.
For a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down.
Next year, Disney is set to release a sequel to the children's classic Mary Poppins.
It's now at least 50 years since the original, and it's probably about time that we had a sequel. It's not going to be a remake of the original, it's the next phase of Mary Poppins, so it has every right to be done, I think, and lovely Emily Blunt is going to play Mary Poppins, and I'm a great fan.
The hills are alive.
Julie is recognised by children all over the world as Mary Poppins, and of course as Fraulein Maria from The Sound of Music. So I thought it was only fitting to hand the rest of this interview over to the next generation, my daughter Amelia.
If you were to be Eliza, how would you greet somebody?
How do you do?
Perfect. How do you do? And can you say the rain in Spain?
The rain in Spain stays rainly.
Mainly.
Stays mainly on the plain.
That's it. But you have to say ain.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Can you still say supercalifragilisticexpialidocious backwards?
Yes. Can you?
I've never been able to.
Never been able to? You want me to try? It's docious aliexpialidocious fragicalirupus.
But that's going a bit too far, don't you think? Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious.
A wonderful lady.
You can still say supercalifragilisticexpialidocious backwards.
It's amazing.
And that production of My Fair Lady that she's done and coming back to Sydney is absolutely sensational.
Oh, right. Mm. And talking about that, My Fair Lady is currently playing at Brisbane's Lyric Theatre. It then heads to Melbourne in May and a return to Sydney in August. For tickets, head to myfairladymusical.com.au. And a big thank you to the wonderful Ange Bishop for that fantastic interview. Mm.